Carly Rae Jepsen began to pursue her professional music career in 2007, while auditioning for Canadian Idol. She finished in third place and was quite relieved that she didn't win, as it drew her attention, but she wasn't forced into a terrible contract. The following year, she released her debut album, Tug of War, which was only effective amongst her niche following, but was a great stepping stool in her career. Years passed, and by 2011, she began working on her second album, which spawned the massive hit Call Me Maybe. They gained exposure after Justin Bieber and other notable teen stars made a viral video dancing to it. And as they say, the rest is history. The song shot straight up the charts all around the globe, spending 9 weeks at the top position in the USA, selling well over 15 million copies worldwide, being certified diamond, and becoming one of the best-selling singles of all time. Following the success of Call Me Maybe, Carly attempted to replicate the success with Good Time, a fun, upbeat duet with Owl City. The song was successful but rather forgettable than its predecessor. Jepsen followed this by releasing her second album titled Kiss, which did moderately well worldwide and went on to produce two more singles titled Curiosity and Tonight I'm Getting Over You. And just like that, she was gone. Failing to replicate the mass success of Call Me Maybe, she was now all forgotten by the general public. Although in 2015, she attempted to supply the world with a repackaged version of CMM titled I Really Like You, it fell flat. This led up to her releasing her third studio album titled Emotion, which to a lot of surprises received great reception and developed her a cult following. The girl who was once a chart-topping mega pop star is now an indie artist.
To be really honest, I liked that song, but it wasn't the song that was like my favorite off the album. And it's a song that, you know, I'm proud that we did. I think the best memory of it was that day of shooting with Tom Hanks. But if my motivation was solely on sales or charts, then I think I would be feeling differently about it. But it's much more about the art of things and creating something that I can be proud of and sharing it with those people who do get it. The album itself, I think, is something that I really, at the end of making it, didn't care if anyone listened to it. I was just really proud of it myself, and I hope I can get to that place with whatever I create in the future.
Although she will most likely never be as high as she once was, her career isn't at all dead yet, as she also dabbled in acting and has been releasing critically acclaimed bodies of work. But for most of us, she will always be attached to that 2012 summer song that was everywhere. Despite her recently releasing critically acclaimed bodies of work, on a general basis, she's all too far gone from our memories. Maybe it's time for her to finally call us because we haven't heard from her in a while. We met her, gave her a number, and never heard from her again. Carly reflected on fear of becoming a one-hit wonder. I'll be honest, yeah, there definitely was a moment where I felt like a little bit, wow, this song Called Me Maybe is working. It's working, it's working. Stop working. Because we were just trying to put out the next single and there was so much attention to this one thing that we almost couldn't beat it. There was a moment or two, a few months I think, where I was sort of like, I don't know, I have a desire to rebel this in a big way. I have a desire to kind of stay paralyzed. As stated by Forbes, Call Me Maybe is just one of those unexpected songs by an obscure artist that suddenly captivates a broad swath of the nation, before quickly disappearing into oblivion, returning periodically at theme playlists or parties to transport listeners to a very specific time and place, and that about sums it up.